Howdy, tubes. How's everybody doing today? Well, it's a Tuesday, heading out here to the truck. This is my first day back from vacation, so getting back into the swing of things here, good old Swift. Oh, sorry about that. Trying to get into the truck and stuff. Oh, goodness gracious. So, took some vacation time and just took vacation time just to kind of goof off and work the other job a little bit and whatnot. And tell you what, when you have a rotation system the way we have it here, the 4 days on and 4 days off, you can't take vacation time on your weekends when you're scheduled for weekends. But, you know, it works out to where you actually have like 12 days off, we can take vacation. And it was freaking awesome. So, yeah, just trying to get back into the swing of things and everything. Haven't really posted a lot. Did the Cosmosphere trip. I've got a couple of really short videos from that. Did that a week ago. Just have been so busy, and my wife's had a lot of stuff she's had to do on the computer and everything. So, my apologies if I haven't gotten that stuff posted, but the Cosmosphere trip was awesome. Highly recommend if you're anywhere in the state of Kansas, Oklahoma, Missouri, or you're passing through it, everything. Oh my goodness, go to the freaking Cosmosphere down in Hutchinson, Kansas, because it has got some cool stuff down there. During the summertime, they do space camp stuff. It costs a little bit of money to send your kids down for that, but, you know, well worth it. Kind of keep the dream alive and the space program alive. If I don't roll my window up, you guys won't be able to hear me at all. But, yeah, they've got a bunch of stuff in there. The Apollo 13 Command Module Odyssey from, if y'all have ever seen the movie Apollo 13, when the capsule sat and just parts just everywhere across the United States after they'd gotten back from the aborted mission. And they took it and got all the parts back and everything and sent it down to the Cosmosphere. And they basically restored it back to post-flight status, how it looked after the flight. And the Smithsonian has it on permanent loan now to the Cosmosphere. So it just looks really awesome and everything. In fact, the Cosmosphere is now an affiliate of the Smithsonian. So that's how cool it is. And when the Apollo 13 movie was made, the craftsmen and the restoration workers from the Cosmosphere are the ones that did a lot of the props and everything. So the command module they use there was done by the folks at the Kansas Comosphere. In fact, they're in the credits three times for the movie. So, yeah, I'm giving a big thumbs up to the Kansas Comosphere. They just got the Liberty Bell 7, Gus Grissom's ship in there. Sat at the bottom of the ocean for like 39 years. Brought it up. They've restored it back. It looks incredible. They've got another, it was one of the Gemini program capsules. I always get Mercury and Gemini confused, so forgive me on that. But they've got another one similar to that one that was, they shot it up to test it. It was unmanned, and the thing blew up. So they have pieces of it, and it's basically in the same shape of the Gemini. Now you have to watch my quick video. I couldn't do too long of a video because, one, it was like 12:45 in the morning, and I was getting a private tour of the Space Museum, and, you know, I couldn't film too much of it. Got a little bit of it, so planning on taking the girls back down there for a trip, hopefully, in June, and take a little bit more vacation. It's now May 7th, 8th, May 8th, so, yeah, I had a blast. I went down with my oldest daughter's Girl Scout troop and got to be kind of being part of a leader with them a little bit, helping out where possible for field trips and stuff like that. Let's see. That's about it. Did a bunch of yard work and whatnot. Swept up the front yard. wife was pretty happy about that. He's been able to help out with that. Yeah, getting back to work, getting back into the remembering how everything works and everything. Just, man, I tell you what. Oh, here's something you guys need to see. There in the distance is a construction crane. We'll be up on that pretty quick here. Cerner is building at minimum, a two-office complex right here at the Legends Village West here in Kansas City, Kansas. And they're just chomping right along at that. They cleared out a lot of space there and everything. And they've got either the first, I think they're starting on like the second or third story of this thing already of the first tower. You guys might be able to see this a little bit before we have to move to take our exit. So, yeah, more construction. I mean, I remember 15 years ago when none of this was out here, the raceway, the new casino that just opened up in February. You know, we're getting a new office complex right there. Can't see it too well, but there's the speedway out in the distance along with the casino and stuff. So, yeah, exciting times happening in my kind of adopted home state. I'm from Missouri myself and have lived a good part of my life on the Kansas side. I'd have to say majority of my life. I was 5 when we moved to Kansas. And I moved Arkansas when I was like 22, I guess it was. So there's like a 17 years basically I spent in Kansas. So I spent 10 years in Arkansas and then I came back to Kansas in 96. Yeah, 96 I believe it was. So, yeah, pretty good. We've been up here ever since. Oh my gosh, 96. Sixteen years. Sorry about that. Math's really cruddy right now. So I've been back up here 14 years. So 14 and 17. You know, 31 right there. So yep. Spent 31 years in the state of Kansas. Not much else going on. I've got a long 5-day stretch at Swift this week. Traded a Saturday for my counterpart so he could go see his daughter graduate this Saturday. So I'm going to take off the Saturday of Memorial Day weekend. And Girl Scouts have another project. Might hopefully get to film a little bit of that. Going to be out at the Leavenworth National Cemetery. Put flags on the grave for Memorial Day weekend. So I thought that was a really important project. Otherwise, I'd been working that Saturday. So, well, speaking of construction, probably can't see it too well back there, but back behind the Wendy's right there is the new Sam's Club that's coming in. Tell you what, this area just growing by leaps and bounds. So, got a new restaurant coming in up here, and yeah. So now just waiting for the light to change. I'm going to do some more videos before too long. Got to wait until I buy a really good camera to really get into it and make some good quality videos for everybody. But yeah, in the meantime, got my little Samsung camera phone here. It doesn't do too bad of a job. Check of the box. Olive Garden. Red Lobster. Put the seafood lover in you. Chick-fil-A, and then the new one, Logan's Roadhouse, which opens up, I think, this month. I don't think they're open yet. No, now hiring sign is up. So, yeah, not quite open yet. So, we'll be long up here and just get headed for home. Got to make a stop at the store to pick up some milk. depending on the price of ice cream, might pick up some ice cream, so we can all have some ice cream for dessert. I'm in kind of a kick. We got a little bit sick while I was off last week for a couple of days. I must have gotten food poisoning or something, but, you know, once you have your gallbladder out, you find a lot of things really don't agree with you anymore. It's been almost a year since I've had mine out, and I find that broccoli is not my friend anymore. I believe tuna now is no longer my friend. It's really too bad I love tuna. It just doesn't love me anymore. And of course, you know, you try to stay away from really, really greasy foods, because, oh, that hurts. So, lost a few pounds while I was sick last week, so that was pretty good. So, excuse me. I need to go to bed earlier tonight, that's for sure. Not 11:30 to bed, 4:30 wake-up call, just a bit too much. Yeah, we're getting into the run here, going up to K7, and we're going to start heading up to town, up to, back up to Leavenworth. So, hoping that everybody has a really good night, and I think we'll just kind of end it right there. Let me just get here on the road. There's more traffic than what I normally see when I'm out here, so a little crazy. It's amazing. It's moving along, getting up to the speed limit, and then all of a sudden someone breaks and someone's turning or something. So, anyway, everybody have a great night, great day, and we'll talk at you later.